Addiction, a strong inclination to do, use, or indulge in something repeatedly. It's 2020. 94% of Americans own a cell phone. The average person spends more than 24 hours per week on their phones, with younger millennials in Generation Z spending 5 hours or more per day on their devices. And while addiction may be somewhat of a strong word to use for this habit, it's something that I think needs to be discussed. A simple question to ask yourself is, what happens to you when you lose your phone? Are you calm, collected, settled, or do you become agitated, impatient, restless? And this is something that I found for myself, that over the years I've become more and more dependent on my phone to the point where I would spend 6 hours per day or more using my device. So this video is to hopefully show you some strategies to get your phone usage down lower so that you can spend more time in the real world, that I found it has helped me quite a bit. Now, don't get me wrong, phones have many wonderful uses. You can call an Uber with the tap of a button, you can call friends from the other side of the world, call an ambulance, navigate a city with maps that you've never been to before. There's many things that phones are very useful for, and I don't want this video to sound as though it's totally against phones. I use my phone still quite often, but I found that using some of these techniques I'm gonna show you in this video, I use it more with a purpose today, rather than just sort of blindly going on to my phone for 6 to 7 or 8 hours per day and sort of just wandering through the social media vortex. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna show you 5 things that I've done to really cut down my phone usage and really just use my phone with more of a purpose. So I noticed that in the past, if I wouldn't have my phone, maybe I forgot it somewhere, I left it at my house, suddenly I'd become antsy. I would start to reach around looking for my phone, and this natural habit of reaching for your pocket all the time, trying to grab your phone, looking at it every 5 minutes, I didn't like the idea that I was so dependent on my phone to rely on it for everything, whether it was using it to navigate or using it to, you know, thinking, well, maybe somebody needs to reach me right now. Maybe someone just sent me a message or a DM on Instagram and it's absolutely important and I just need to always have my phone on and respond to it right away. And I think probably the biggest problem that I had with this was not actually that I was distracted and spending so much time on it, but rather that it was really killing my workflow. So if you're trying to do anything really and succeed in something, whether you're trying to write a book or maybe you're studying for an exam, I found that if you have your phone next to you and it's going off every 5 minutes, it's buzzing, you're getting email notifications, Instagram DMs, you're getting text messages, phone calls, it can be incredibly distracting. And if you've watched videos on this channel in the past before, you'll know that I'm a big advocate for kind of block scheduling and making sure that you can focus on certain tasks throughout your day without very many distractions. So one of the things that I wanted to do was I thought, okay, how can I get my phone usage down? And I think the simple kind of answer to that would be, well, why don't you just turn off your phone? Or why don't you put it in a different room or lock it away, as I did in the past, and I got actually a special lockbox for it, and it worked pretty well. But I found that it really wasn't as good as what I thought it would be, because there were things that I wanted to use my phone for that I wasn't able to do. If I locked my phone away, if I turned it off, I wouldn't be able to use a calculator very quickly, or if I wanted to check the weather in just 15 seconds. It's nice to have your phone for those purposes. So what I found is not just getting rid of it entirely or by turning it off all day, but I found a better method was, first of all, turning off all phone notifications. So I literally get no notifications throughout the day. I might get a couple from text messages from certain specific people that I have notifications on for. Other than that, I don't get notifications. Instagram, even YouTube. If you're new here to the channel, I'll make sure you subscribe and maybe turn on the notification. But Snapchat notifications, TikTok, email, everything, I have everything off so that it's not buzzing all the time and it's in silent mode. And so I'm just not bothered. I'm not always kind of getting a reason to pick up my phone, and then suddenly, so you get one notification from somebody who messaged you on Instagram, you read their message and then you click on their profile and then you look at their post, and then they tag somebody in that post, and then you click on that person's profile, and then you spend time there, and you end up in what we call the social media vortex, where suddenly an hour goes by, 2 hours go by, and you're on just random Instagram pages. You have no idea how you got there, and you're just kind of killing time, wasting time. And so by just picking up your phone less throughout the day, it's going to incentivize you less to spend time in the social media vortex. So I found that there were really 3 primary uses for my phone, reasons why I was picking it up, and if I could pick it up less, then I would just be using it less in the social media vortex. So one of the main reasons why I was checking my phone is because I was checking the time. I wanted to see what time it was. I do this multiple times per hour, you need to be at meetings, you need to be somewhere on time. So you pick up your phone, you look at the time, and then suddenly you see your messages and it goes on and on. So simple fix to that, I just got a watch. It was that simple. So now when I want to know the time, I just look at my watch instead of needing to pick up my phone. Another reason why I was using my phone quite a bit was by just checking messages, responding to messages. I felt like I was really, I had responded to messages on time. Now I just kind of batch those together, or I do bulk messaging. So if I get 5 text messages in the span of 2 hours, I'll just respond to all of them at the same time and then put my phone away and have notifications off and then check it every few hours rather than just kind of going and responding to everyone as they come in, just kind of batching them together. And then the third thing that I was doing was I was reading a lot of email and checking email and getting notifications. So what I did for that is I just got rid of most of my email accounts on my phone. So now what I do with my email is I just use it for my laptop. I just have it on my computer. And that just saves me a lot of time of having to go through and look through all of that on my phone. It's a lot easier to do that because I try to really have email just for work rather than getting like coupons and stuff in my inbox. All right, so as you can see, I have plenty of apps on my phone, but I've gotten rid of most of the apps that just aren't really productive or aren't helpful to me. So a lot of the games or these other little just kind of apps that really I wasn't using very often and they were cluttering my phone. So I try to keep my phone kind of sort of minimalistic, and I think that really helps as well. But you'll also notice probably that my phone is black and white. It's gray. And so you can actually put your phone in grayscale mode if you just go to color filters and you can change it to black and white. And what this does is it kind of makes certain things less interesting, which I like because, for example, if I go on Instagram, I kind of just view Instagram sort of as kind of like the newspaper, right? Like I see people's posts, but they're not extremely interesting. They don't catch my eye as much. So I found that this really helps me cut back on the amount of time that I'm actually spending on actual Instagram. And so I think that's pretty cool. And it really does save me quite a bit of time. So I've been doing this for a couple of months now, and I think I've seen quite a few benefits from this. Obviously my workflow increased, I was able to get much more done in my day, but I think the best part of this is that I was able to have more genuine connections with people in the real world, real conversations, rather than kind of in the social world, the social media world. I think a lot of people, you know, if you're sitting at Thanksgiving dinner, I see this in so many American families today, where people are sitting at the dinner table and they're just all on their phones. They're all just texting each other or other people instead of just making eye contact with someone and having a real conversation. And I think that's something that's shifting quite a bit in these coming years, but I just really like having real conversations with people. And so my challenge to you is to try to do something similar to this. My phone usage used to be probably about 6 hours per day, and it's much closer to about an hour or 2 hours per day. Obviously, there's some times where I'm going to use my phone for productivity. I need to use a calculator. I use my notes in my phone. So I don't strictly limit how much time. I'm not going to set a quota of saying I have to do a less than an hour per day on my phone, because sometimes I'll spend 3 or 4 hours on my phone, but it's focused on things that are important tasks or things that I really think are essential to get done. So my challenge to you is to try doing this, to just see if you can use some of these tactics, maybe grayscale mode, maybe just turning off most notifications and having real conversations with other people. So thanks for watching the video. Appreciate all the support. We're coming up on 500,000 subscribers now. It's absolutely blowing my mind. And I'll see everybody in next week's video.